All right, for the last representation of our four-year series, we're going to look at our real value in a different way. Let's define this as a real value. This real value can be identified by two different points. The point up here at positive j, and the point down here at negative j. And we have defined this because we have already solved for the exponential form of the Fourier series. So we know that we can find these two complex conjugates to define the real value. And I'll also label here the theta at which they're at. So let's say that this real value is equal to the coefficient at positive j, or the positive nth iteration, e j to the n w naught t plus the coefficient at negative n e j negative n w naught t. Now we know that since these are complex conjugates, the coefficients in magnitude should be the same, except for, of course, their phases. So we'll include that by replacing the coefficients with the magnitude of cn times e. This one is at positive omega n. Then we'll bring this back down, e j n w naught t. Then our negative coefficient is equal to the magnitude of cn e to the negative j theta n. Bring this back down, e j negative n w naught t. Now we can distribute out this magnitude of the coefficient and combine the exponents. So e to the j n w naught t plus theta n plus e to the negative j n w naught t plus theta n. Now we can use Euler's formula one more time to convert these two exponents into a cosine. So we're going to end up getting cn, the magnitude of cn, times 2 cosine n w naught t plus theta n. And as a generic representation for our function in the time domain, we can write this in terms of a sum. So we get the sum of n at 0 to infinity of dn cosine n w naught t plus theta n. Where dn here is going to be equal to 2 cn. Also, at the origin, I'm sorry, when the angle is 0, we can define d naught as equal to c naught. Now, why is this so? If we take a couple of steps back, we know this is the Euler's formula representation for cosine. So if we plug in 0 for theta, we'll get e to the 0 plus e to the negative, okay, j over 2. So then we'll end up getting 1 plus 1 over 2 equals 1. So that's why our d naught is going to be equal to co. So here we can just add CO. And this right here is going to be the one last representation of the Fourier series in terms of a combined trigonometric function cosine. Thank you for watching. Please check out our website for more HKM videos. Hope this helps.